Welcome back, everyone. This week in Introduction to Equine Studies, we'll be covering colors of the horse. There are limitless variations of coat colors, and the primary ones include bay, brown, gray, chestnut, palomino, Appaloosa, buckskin, blue and red roan, as well as black and paint. To be able to identify these colors correctly, join me in a quick review. To start, one of the most common coat colors in horses is called bay. The horses have a solid brown body, ranging anywhere from reddish brown to almost black. Bay is the general term used for horses of this color, but variations within have specified terms such as blood bay or bright bay. Bay horses also have what is referred to as black points. In reference to coloring, points on a horse include their muzzle, ear tips, mane, tail, lower legs, and hooves. As you can see here in this horse, he has all black points and a solid brown body coat, defining him as a bay-colored horse. Keep in mind that a color typically confused with bay is called brown, such as this horse here. Brown horses still have primarily all black points and always have a brown body coat, but differ from bays in that they have what are called mealy-colored muzzles, or oatmeal-colored hair on their face and flanks. Gray horses are another interesting color to consider. When gray horses are first born, they actually appear black, such as the foal you see in this picture. Eventually, this young colt will shed out into what his mother looks like. Because gray horses continue to lighten in color as they mature, it is easy for old gray horses to be mistaken for white. However, the reason why gray horses are given their title is because of their skin color. All gray horses have black skin. Their black points will fade with maturity, creating several different coat patterns as they do so. This here is a dappled gray, and you can tell because of the circular dark gray patterns that cover his body. Next up is the chestnut. Chestnut-colored horses are common in just about every breed of horse, and range from very dark tones to very light tones. The one you see here is a medium chestnut. Chestnut horses have all brown body coats and all brown points, but one of the most stunning versions of chestnut is titled the liver chestnut. A liver chestnut is the darkest acceptable version of a chestnut you can have, and is renowned for his handsome look. This horse here is an excellent example of a liver chestnut. The palomino is another popular color amongst horse enthusiasts. It has an unmistakable golden-colored coat with a cream-colored mane and tail. In the winter months, faded palominos can appear an all-over cream color, sometimes making them seem all one shade, such as this horse here. But in the summer months, the definition between their body coat colors and their mane and tail become clear, such as the picture you see of this Marin foal. This particularly different coat color is called the Appaloosa. Appaloosas are characterized by having solid base coats covered with varying patterns of dark spots. Appaloosa horses were originally bred by the Native Americans and were used on the plains for hunting, cherished for their unique look. Today, Appaloosas have developed into a color-specific breed and come in many different spotted patterns. The one you see here is called a leopard Appaloosa. The horse in this picture is called a buckskin. The primary difference between a buckskin horse and a bay-colored horse is their base color. A buckskin horse is always light tan on their body, while a bay horse is a deeper brown. Buckskin horses have all black points and are known for their golden appearance in the summer months. Here we have a blue roan horse. Roans are especially interesting because they are a direct mix of two colors. A blue roan horse is a horse with a black base coat with white hairs mixed in. This gives him the blue appearance. The other version of a roan is called a red roan. Red roans are horses with a chestnut base coat with white hairs mixed in, thus giving them a red hue. Roan horses always have darker points than their base coat. As you can see in this red roan mare, she has dark chestnut points on her face, legs, mane, and tail. Here you see a true black horse. While it may seem obvious at first, black horses are often mistaken for dark bay or dark brown. To help you distinguish the difference, always pay close attention to the points of a black horse. If the horse's coat is true black and all of his points are black, then he is indeed a genuine black-coated horse, such as this Arabian you see here. Finally, the last coat color we are going to discuss is a paint horse. Paint horses come in many different variations and patterns to describe their colored splotches, just like the Appaloosas do. However, paints are different in that they have large areas of color that are different from their base coat, rather than just small spots. Paints can come in brown and white, black and white, tan and white, or bay and white. As you have seen, horses come in many different colors, but hopefully now you've grasped a better understanding of horse colors and will be able to identify them out in the field. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.